cards as a meditation. And those he plays never suspect. He doesn't play.
Welcome guys to Marine Tactical here, and today I'm doing a video on the Hogue Monogrip. It's going to be a review. So this is the only mod that I've installed so far on my Taurus tracker. This is a very popular firearm, or actually it's gaining popularity for that matter. My last video kind of blew up, so that was kind of cool. So thanks again guys for the support, and I'm super happy that I got 500 subscribers. So anyway, without further ado, let's get into it. First thing that I always do, as you guys know if you're a long-term subscriber of mine, I always like to safety check. You'll have to bear with me because I'm doing this with one hand as well. So we are empty. All right, impressions. So the first impressions that I really like about this monogrip is that it's kind of minimally textured, but at the same time it's not super aggressive. See, the issue with the river grip that came stock on the trackers is that it, while it seemed like a good idea at first, once you go up the scale of the higher weights, the higher bullet weights, as in 300 grain, you'll start to notice shock in your hand, and it's pretty painful at first. So that's why I grabbed this, and I noticed I was able to endure the punishment a lot longer of the 44 Magnum. So the grip definitely helped with the recoil. It also, again, look at that, it helps you get really close to the bore, as high up as you possibly can, so you can really get in behind the gun and kind of deal with the recoil the best way you can. And you know, that never gets old with revolvers. I'm sorry, I just love the single action, kind of something about it. So also, at this point in time, I know I haven't kept up with videos, and I'm doing the best that I possibly can, but this at this point has now had about 500 rounds through it. Not exactly economical, and the only damage that's been done to the firearm is actually, excuse me, the only damage that has been done in general is to my pocket. So as you know, 44 Magnum is not cheap, but it's actually held up extremely well. There's no frame cracking. I mean, you guys can totally just kind of look and see that it's fairly clean. You know, there's nothing, you know, that's one of the most common things you'll find in any high pressure round, especially 357 Magnum or 10 millimeter or 40 Smith & Wesson. You know, you'll notice that your frame will begin to crack. And with 44 Magnum, on poorly built firearms, you'll notice cracking. But this seems to be doing pretty well. There's no chafing or scratches in the chamber walls. That's just carbon. The crane still operates fairly well. Doesn't stick. Just goes right back into place. So, despite what people may think about these firearms, the tracker is actually an excellent firearm. And I definitely think if you're in the mood to purchase one, don't be afraid of it. It's pretty decent quality. You can't really go wrong with it. So yeah, that's what I would say. And the first mod I would do, hands down, absolutely, would be to grab yourself a Hogue Monogrip. It's just, it's worth the money. It's $20. Get it over with, the best $20 you'll ever spend. And just look at this firearm. It just looks beautiful. You would never tell that this is a sub $500 handgun, actually revolver. It's 44 Magnum at that. It's a budget hand cannon, guys. So again, I kind of just love the looks of it. All right, guys, thanks for watching my video. Thank you for the support. Be safe, have fun,